In this pivot table, we're showing the sum of quantity sold in each region and within the cities in that region. If we wanted to see a count of the orders, we could add the quantity field again and instead of sum, show a count, and that would create another column here. Another way of showing the count, though, is to use a subtotal. Right now, we have a subtotal for each region showing the total sum for the east and the west, and we can change that, so instead of just one subtotal, there are two or more subtotals. To do that, I'm going to right-click on one of the region names and click Field Settings. And in the Field Settings dialog box, on the Subtotals and Filters tab, we can see that Subtotals is set for automatic. I'll select Custom, and then I can click on one or more of these built-in summary functions. So if I want to continue to see the sum, I'll click Sum, and I'd like the count as well, so I'll use Count, and then click OK. And now instead of that default subtotal that we had, we now have the sum and the count for each region. You'll notice, though, that only applies to the quantity column. We also have a calculated field here, which is taking the total amount of dollars of that sale and multiplying it by 0.05. So for that calculated field, we don't get these custom subtotals. So if you're using calculated fields, you might want to continue using automatic subtotals instead of these custom ones. The inner fields here, we have region is the outer field and city is the inner field, and they don't automatically get any kind of subtotal. So if I want to see subtotals for those, I can right-click one of the city names, go to Field Settings, and again, in this Field Settings dialog box, it's set for automatic. I'll click Custom, and then I could click Sum or Count. Now I can already see the total sum for each city, so I'll just select Count here and click OK. And all of the subtotals for those cities appear after the last region. So below the second region that we have, you can see all the city counts. And then finally the grand total. So you can't rearrange these, they're just in the order that they appear in the pivot table, and they come before the grand total, so you can't change that, but at least you can see the count for each city without adding another column to your pivot table.